Right now, I'd like to pass the mic to Joe Archer, who's gonna share with us how to actually use Lifelike with OneNote and how to share some of the images and other resources that you can create with Lifelike.
Alrighty, thank you very much, Martin. I used screenshots of Lifelike material I wanted to include. Within the Clipper, you can grab it in a full page. You can grab an article, a region, bookmark. So on here, you can see that this is the article side here. So you can pull that, you can clip it straight from the Lifelike resource and insert it directly, as you can see here, into your space that you're working in that you want to drop it into, which is quite convenient. And it's very smooth and it clips right there. Super easy, quite helpful. Student material. Students started exploring this material in the collaboration space within their OneNote binder that we had for the classroom. They began interacting, diving deeper into the intense conversations, started tracking, gathering more insights, gathering information on what we're exploring. For me, I love walking around. I love photographing and documenting videos and all this sort of things. And I think that's a kindergarten teacher in me expanding into grade 5, grade 6 this year. And listening to those conversations for those teachable moments are huge, and I love that piece. So one other device that kind of I use in my classroom, just like Tammy, is I got this awesome screen beam, and I love this thing because it allows me to take what the kids are learning live at that moment and project it and share what they're talking about. So things that were transpiring at the tip of the kids' fingers. Children were able to share that information up there on the board with a click of a button. Students could then share with the entire class right from their seats. They became the leaders, and all that learning that it started occurring within the room. So instead of being teacher directed, now you're looking at your peers. And I always look back on my time in school and that, the teacher being the dictator in the class, not super engaging. But when your peers are up there, you're always turn on the light there and you're listening a little more intently. And, it's very empowering for these kids. And it's inspiring, listening to your other classmates, and you get a lot from each other. And the learning became really powerful when you're using Lifelike within that OneNote classroom, utilizing screen beam as well. So just add the Clipper, the OneNote Clipper, you have these options. As you can see the full page option here on the left where you can pull in all this the information here and insert quickly into a OneNote. You have the regional piece where you can actually photograph, like grab the whole region piece here along with information on the other side as well, and insert directly into whatever notebook you're going to drop them into. So that's a couple options there. The other two options pop up as this, a full page view, and then the actual article, as you seen a little bit earlier, where you can just drop the information in. So this information the kids would take a look at in the collaboration space. They would dive into analyzing what's happening in there. The International Space Station is the largest orbiting spacecraft ever built. A lot of them were talking about, who built it? Was it just us? Was it the States? Was there anyone else involved? So then there was discussion, trying to find out who else was involved, the other 11 nations that were involved in creating it and whatnot. So then they started looking at analyzing what people contributed. And being a Canadian, one of the biggest things that's really empowering for us Canadians is the Canada arm that's part of the International Space Station. So one of the kids actually expanded so much into his speech and talked about how Canada inspires innovation and utilize the sorry the Canada arm within his speech to share his thoughts and feelings about how we contribute on a global scale in Canada, which is quite cool. Anyway, so how do you find and download the OneNote Clipper? Here's a quick little video that I have in here. It's about 3 minutes long. Sometimes these videos don't really work on these PowerPoints, so there is links down below. So in order to download it, it takes a little bit of time with things lagging a bit for me. I'm hoping maybe you guys can take a peek at it later and be able to download through it. I'm not as lucky as others with things, so I just want to make sure I get through the material here. Anyway, so I want to show you my OneNote digital space breakout, and at the end of this, as you can see at the bottom of the slide there, there's a bit.ly link that you're more than welcome to jump into and utilize. So it's there, free. Enjoy. I hope you have a blast with it. I've got Flipgrid in there. I've got Minecraft build, Scratch, Sways, different PowerPoints where you're learning material and whatnot. And as you can see on here, there's a bunch of extras and whatnot. And it's focused on the curriculum expectations in grade 6. However, there's a lot of other stuff I threw in there. Just some of the passion projects or passion information pieces that I really enjoy that I think kids would love too. So within my OneNote breakout room, I added in Lifelike, where I integrated it in as a link. As you can see here on the left, to investigate the International Space Center space station even more, venture over to this incredible new program called Lifelike. Click the blue link here. And then throughout my space breakout, it's our Canadian icon in space, Commander Chris Hadfield, that's navigating the kids through this breakout itself. So here, Chris Hadfield would like you to know. Next night sky, what is the brightest object in the sky? So if you click to the link, it'll give you information in all lowercase letters, no spaces, and what last year did really well with it, and it that power up the International Space Station that keep it up the moon. And so they would click on the next blockage, and the password would be sort of that's blockage 11. Blockage 12 on my thingy, it says you can explore more space resources such as these over on the other side. Here's blockage 12 on the right. So welcome to the vast assortment of incredible lifelike resources to explore. These are order. I'm really sorry. There's the O right on slide 8 that you can actually utilize to get to that, to see all that information and whatnot, how to do that.